I've seen these guys. They're so buff. This is Suzy Watt of 99.7 The Bits. It's the Arnold Schwarzenegger Bodybuilding Classic. It's here today at Vets Memorial in Columbus, Ohio. And I got to tell you, folks, it's bigger than ever before. People are coming from everywhere.
That's right. The Arnold Classic is huge. It's even bigger than me. People are coming here by foot, by train, by plane, by bus, and even by helicopter. Me, I come with my favorite vehicle in the world because this is the only car that can guarantee me a very special parking space. Watch. You see, this is a very big bodybuilding competition, the biggest in the world. I mean, you want to see huge arms? Wait when you see the gigantic arms of Vince Taylor. You want to talk mass? Wait when you see Paul Gillette. He's an absolute monster. Or you want to talk about compact? Flavio Paccinini, 4'11", zero body fat. You see, this is the cream of the crop. That's why I want you to stay here right with me. No flipping channels, no Saturday afternoon movies, not even mine. Just watch this show. Otherwise I get mad, believe me.
This is Columbus, Ohio, the capital city of the Buckeye State, and today the site of a very special physical fitness event. The auditorium, Veterans Memorial Auditorium, is sold out. This is the toughest ticket in Ohio. They've come for the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic. Hello, everyone. I'm Don Crickey. This classic has become one of the signal events in the worldwide explosion in physical fitness. In truth, some of the best bodybuilders in the world are here, but it is much more than that. It really is a physical fitness happening that sells out the hotels in the city of Columbus, and people from around the world come, and this burgeoning event gets bigger and bigger every year. I'm joined by the man it's named after, the most acclaimed bodybuilder in the history of the sport, Arnold Schwarzenegger. And Arnold, I know you're proud of the growth of this. It's been tremendous.
You're absolutely correct. This is now the biggest bodybuilding competition in the world. The Arnold Classic is the best and most important event. Then we have the convention, of course, here, and the Fitness Expo, which is the largest in America. It's really becoming a major event, and I'm very excited again to see the top bodybuilders here in Columbus.
And that's what we're going to look at now, the vie for the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic title. And we'll go over the rules of how it breaks down for this final event. The competition consists of four rounds. Number one is standing relaxed. Number two, compulsory poses. Number three, free pose. And number four, the pose down. At the conclusion of round two, the athletes are ranked and the field is pared down eventually to six finalists. And here are the finalists we'll be seeing in rounds three and four, the free pose and the pose down rounds. Vince Taylor, a former champion, Aaron Baker, Chris Cormier, Porter Cottrell, and Kevin Lavroni. Now ready to go to work in the free pose is one of the oldest competitors and one of the best, the man they call Vince the Prince, Vince Taylor of Pembroke Pines, Florida, 37 years old.
Yeah, Vince Taylor is obviously the crowd's favorite. He has been here several times before. He's a terrific competitor and he's known to have really the most perfect body. You can't really find weak points there, so he has a good chance of winning this competition.
He is a very skilled poser. He has a kind of that Terminator look on his face, huh?
That's right.
He'll
wise
be back.
Choice. Wise choice.
Vince is on top of his game right now, too. He's coming off a recent win in the Mr. Ironman.
Momentum here is everything. It's extremely important to win one championship, win the next, and go on like that. So here, this is really, he can show you how the audience feedback has an effect on you, and it brings more energy into your posing routine. And then the more energy you bring into your posing, the more reaction you get from the audience. And that, again, plays a very important part on the judges right now, because they feel, wait a minute, obviously the audience likes them as much as we do, and it will have an effect on the points.
He
really plays the crowd well.
He does.
Yeah.
Actor Gregory Hines likes it.
Nothing like some water, huh?
37 years old, the oldest of the finalists, and obviously a guy that could be the favorite to win it.
Oh, it's not owing to the fat lady sings. I think she just sung.
We'll have more from the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic in a moment. We're in the shadow of the Lincoln Levesque Tower in Columbus, Ohio, at the 6th annual Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic. Now coming out to pose is Aaron Baker. He's 33 years old from Venice, California. He's been a professional for 4 years. Interesting guy, a former Mr. California. He works as an actor and model in Los Angeles, and he's also, Arnold, a comic book artist.
Tremendous arm development. You can see the arms, deltoids, and thighs are really the body parts that he can be most proud of. As you can see here, he lacks in calves. He really needs at least 2, 2.5, or even 3 inches of calves in order to match his thighs to show good proportions. I think this will really cost him points today. You can see here in the calves that he really needs much more muscle development. He needs 2 to 3 inches more in his calves. This is really a weak point, and it sticks out as a weak point.
Boy. Hard work, baby.
Along with the prestige of winning the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic comes a prize of $90,000 for the winner, with a total purse of $250,000. And here is one of the good young bodybuilders, Chris Cormier. He's in his first year as a professional and very highly regarded already.
Chris weighs 240 pounds with a height of 5'10". So I think that you see here a lot of muscles, a lot of tensity.
This is Chris Cormier, a 26-year-old, trains out of Venice, California. Mentioned a rookie on the pro tour, but he's been at the bodybuilding game for a long time, a former teenage national champion for Mr. California. And last year, he was Mr. USA.
Absolutely. I think he is a very fast rising star in the bodybuilding circuit. He improves very quickly. He learns from each one of those competitions, and his posing improves continuously. Very smooth, very graceful. He's flexing the total back, the center back, the upper back, deltoids, everything.
Arnold, how long does it take for a bodybuilder from the time he starts to get good till he really reaches his peak?
Some bodybuilders take longer than others, but the ideal thing is that you move carefully and steadily up. That you win the Mr. California, Mr. USA, Mr. America, Mr. Universe, and each year win a title or two and never stop. So you gain a certain momentum. And a guy like him, he has gained now a certain momentum, so he's really, that really works to his advantage. If you start stopping and go down again and up and down again, that could backfire, and eventually you're not considered a serious contender.
Another interesting aspect of this sport is how exhausting it is to pose. I mean, this wears people out.
It's very exhausting, and you're absolutely correct, because you can lose up to 6 or 7 pounds during one performance in an afternoon or during a competition like that. So I think it is a very strenuous thing, although maybe it doesn't look like it.
Bodybuilders in this and similar competitions face a very long day. Beginning in the early afternoon with rounds 1 and 2, the athletes go under the microscope. First in a standing, relaxed position, and then are required to execute compulsory poses. Symmetry, proportion, muscularity, and overall development are keys to surviving the early rounds. Now we're going to look at one of the top competitors, 33 years old, a firefighter from Louisville, Kentucky, Porter Cottrell.
He looks terrific.
He has very little body fat. He really whipped himself in great shape for this competition. I think that he has a good chance again to be definitely in the top six. Here he should put his stomach in much more. He lets his stomach hang out on a pose like that, which says to the judges, you know, he's maybe fat. But in the meantime, he's not fat. I guarantee you, he doesn't have much body fat at all. But he has no control over his abdominal muscles, or at least very little. That will cost him points today, I'm inevitably.
Cottrell.
Here, this is a big mistake. He's letting the stomach out. He does not control it well. He does not pull it in and make a vacuum. So the judges maybe misinterpret that and think that it's fat, but in fact, he does have very little fat.
Stay with us. We'll review the Ms. International contest when we come back. Welcome back to the 6th Annual Arnold Schwarzenegger Bodybuilding Classic. Here's the very talented Kevin Lavrone, who last year made an amazing comeback from injury and adversity.
The things that happened in my life that got me to this point of where I'm at now is almost like a puzzle, you know? Because my mother died and she had cancer, and then I got into the nutritional part of taking care of my body, and I joined the gym because I wanted to be physical fit. That's what drove me when I went to the gym. I ripped my pec in January, and it wasn't until June to where I could do something in the gym that will make me feel like I'm half of a person.
There was that uncertainty. Would he or would he not be able to come back?
So I did things totally different in the gym that I've never even did before.
Come on, champ, you know what you got to do to win this.
Now, the fact that he got such a good result, well, I put it back, and God healed the wounds, but it's strictly a testament to his determination and hard work, the kind of result that he got.
I had to get in that Olympia, and I had to walk on that stage, and I had to let them people know, you know, that, hey, this is it. I walked out on that stage after 8 months after ripping my pec, and 3 months of training and placed fifth. It felt like it was heaven sent, like it was a gift from God, you know.
When he took part in the Mr. Olympia competition last year, no bodybuilder had ever come back from such a severe injury to compete at this world-class level.
Look at his deltoid muscles and his arm muscles from the back. See, the trick here is that to show to the judges within a short period of time that you have your back developed as well as your front, regardless if you talk about the back development or the arm development, the deltoids, it has to look impressive from the front and from the back. You always try to turn around and show to the judges, kind of saying to them, look, the back is perfect, look now, I turn to the front is perfect.
Impressive free pose session for Kevin Lavrone. Looks like he got some right
good.
In
look
at the
deltoids. Perfect.
Thanks to all my fans and everyone who believed in me.
I would put him in the top three. I mean, maybe it's very early to say that, but I tell you, that was very impressive, his routine and his body. Here you can see that how well his back is developed, how defined it is, how well the center back is developed, and the outside of the back, the V-shape, the deltoids, the trapezius muscles. Also, his arms are very well developed from behind. So all that is very important to score high points.
That completes the free pose portion of the competition. The pose down round will follow shortly. Earlier today, on the same stage, the Ms. International contest was held.
Miss International, Laura Crevel.
Laura Crevel of Old Orchard Beach, Maine, thus becomes the Miss International champion for the second time in 4 years. The weekend's activities include a special photo opportunity with our host. This year, over 1,500 fans formed a line 5 blocks long and anxiously waited to get a personal photograph with the one and only Arnold Schwarzenegger. This is also the site of the world's largest fitness expo, a spectacular display of fitness equipment, clothing, and supplements, and Arnold is always there. Speaking of little, this is Flavio Baccanini, a native of Italy, now living in San Francisco. He says he's the shortest bodybuilder on the world circuit in years, 4'11", 145 pounds.
That's what I meant earlier when I said tensity. You talk about tensity, this is the guy. I mean, he has so much muscle packed on his body with his, 4'11". Imagine you have so much muscle on him. It's incredible.
Sometimes it's an handicap, sometimes it's a great advantage because I look so different from everybody else. Sometimes it's a disadvantage because the judges, they always look up, they never look down.
Well, these judges must have been looking up because Flavio Baccanini was one of 6 bodybuilders who failed to make the cut. But these bodybuilders did make it, and they'll have one final chance to impress the judges when we come back with the pose down. We're in Columbus, Ohio, overlooking the home of the Ohio State Buckeyes, and inside Veterans Memorial Auditorium and set for the pose down, a very important phase of this competition. It's the last chance to impress the judges.
Well, this is, as you said, the most important phase of the competition, because that's the time where there are several bodybuilders that are very close right now, that are maybe 1 point apart, or that are maybe even. And this is the time now where you can really separate yourself and win. Or if you make mistakes, that's where you can lose your battle. So you can see here that all the guys are kind of jumping next to each other and trying to show to the judges that their arm development, their deltoid development is better than the next guy next to him. And so that is what's going on. So it's a very important and very intense phase of the whole pose down right now.
The 6 finalists are Andreas Munzer, Aaron Baker, Chris Cormier, Vince Taylor, Order Cottrell, and Kevin Lebrun.
So the psychology is very important here. To show the sportsmanship look right now, to let the judges know, listen, I'm a good guy. And in case there's any question about the point, you're trying to use everything at this point here.
And that concludes the actual posing, and now it's in the hands of the judges. We asked 2 of the favorites what it would mean to win the Arnold Classic.
Oh, this is the start of a new career. This is the elevation of bodybuilding career for me. If I win this for 94, it's all over. You know, 94 until 96 until I'm ready to stop.
It's an honor to be here and to be invited to this invitational. It would be a great, great honor to win.
And here's the trophy that's emblematic of the championship. Arnold has now moved backstage to interview the winner. His lovely wife, Maria Shriver of NBC News, awaits with this sold-out Veterans Memorial crowd for the announcement of the awards. A little while ago, the most muscular man title went to Vince Taylor of Pembroke Pines, Florida. Now for the announcement of the championship.
The 4th place finisher is definitely the real deal, Chris Cormier.
Here is the 4th place finisher at the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic. This is a rookie on the Pro Tour, the former U.S. amateur champion, and the reigning Mr. USA from a year ago, Chris Cormier of Venice, California.
the third place award worth $25,000 to Porter Cottrell.
And the third place finisher, the fireman from Louisville, Kentucky, Porter Cottrell. And with Porter's third place finish comes a check for $25,000. Porter is 33 years old. Been a professional for just 3 years. And now we come to the final two.
And Kevin, who do you vote for?
Kevin Lavrone and Vince Taylor.
The second place winner is Vince Taylor.
37-year-old Vince Taylor, one of the popular figures in bodybuilding, is the second place finisher. And with that finish comes a check for $45,000. And that means that Kevin Lavrone from Glen Burnie, Maryland, is the new champion of the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic. Here is the final order of finish, with $90,000 going to Kevin Lavrone, and he's with Arnold right now.
Kevin, congratulations for winning the Arnold's Classic Trophy. What does it mean to you?
Me winning this contest means a lot to me, Arnold. I waited a long time to wait to do your contest, especially after the injury. I wanted to get here last year, but I couldn't make it, so I had to go back to the drawing board and train harder and come back. It also, winning the Arnold Classic, gives me an opportunity to further my career. I'm involved with a lot of charity work, you know, helping kids and everything, and this title definitely helped me be a champion in their eyes as well.
When did you feel that you finally had it and that you won the competition?
After my posing routine. In the middle of my posing routine, I noticed the crowd response, so I knew that I must have been doing something right. And it wasn't until after the routine that's when I felt really good.
Well, congratulations, and I hope you come back.
Thank you.
So Kevin Lavrone's comeback story is now complete. He's the 1994 champion of the Arnold Schwarzenegger Classic. Now for Arnold Schwarzenegger, this is Don Cricky. Glad you could be with us in Columbus, Ohio.
A little slower.